Hello everybody, my name is Punarvas Jaikumar. I am a chartered accountant, passionate trainer. I have trained over 15,000 CA students in a career spanning of over 10 years. I am extremely excited and fortunate to be partnering with an academy for CA Foundation, and I'll be handling business laws and DCR paper. So my dear friends, if you want any sort of updates, anything for that matter, I would strongly suggest you right now go and download the Unacademy app. Just go to Play Store, just type Unacademy, and you will get Unacademy learning app, and you can just install the same. And if you want any kind of updates, notes, tips, audio tips, video tips, etc., please join my exclusive Unacademy Law channel. It's called PJ Law. Go to t.me/PJLaw and it'll take you right to my channel, and you can enjoy important notes, audio clips, video clips, etc. And guys, we also have our exclusive CA Foundation English channel, where all the educators and learners come together. This is exclusive English channel, so please join our Telegram channel, CA Foundation English, as well. My dear friends, an exciting announcement. We have already started the CA Warrior Batch. This is a fast track batch for CA Foundation December 21 examination. It is going to be exclusively in English. We have already started. Paper 2 will be handled by me, Punarvas Jaikumar, and the quant portion will be handled by my very good friend and a co-educator, CA Neeraj Mahajan sir. You are gonna love his classes. So we will cover very all important topics, and in law we will cover everything exhaustively, and DCR will do a quick revision. PDF notes will be shared. So as far as law is concerned, it's gonna be from August 18 to maybe since now exam has been postponed to December. We'll also have it in the October first week or something. And exhaustive analysis of paper number 2. Live classes, guys, it's not recorded. Live classes, there will be quizzes, there will be doubt solving sessions, and unlimited access. You can watch it anytime, anywhere apart from live. I will also discuss the presentation techniques. I'll also give you revision notes, Q&A notes, and specially curated handcrafted color charts for one day before the exam, revision. It's going to be almost 60 plus hours. Sir, I also want to check some demo classes, if you feel like that. Guys, these classes are on Unacademy Plus. So unless you have a subscription of Unacademy Plus or Unacademy Iconic, you cannot access these classes. Alright. However, if you want some other revision classes, free classes, if you want free sessions, please download the Unacademy app. Go to the special classes section. Get access to our free special classes by various amazing educators, and you will also earn credits while you watch them. So please check out the free special classes option. On that note, my dear friends, let us begin today's session. So next concept, guys, is the concept of impossibility. In impossibility, we'll discuss this, the concept capsule, very, very important for the exam. Impossibility of the performance, impossibility. Impossibility, two types. One is inherent impossibility, one more is supervening impossibility. One is inherent impossibility, one more is supervening impossibility. Inherent impossibility means what, guys? It is impossible from the beginning. Supervening impossibility means what? Initially possible, later impossible. Inherent impossibility, impossible from the beginning. Supervening impossibility, later. Initially possible, later impossible. One second, guys. I'll just restart this modem. One second. Yes, inherent impossibility means it is void from the beginning, void ab initio. Subsequent impossibility is like a void contract. Correct, Murali. Very good. It is a void contract. Inherent impossibility is void ab initio. Subsequent impossibility is void contract. Initially valid, later it becomes void. So if basically we would have already discussed what is void contract. Like for example, initially liquor trading is valid, but later they may say trading in liquor may be void. So then it becomes void. So, inherent impossibility means what? A agrees with B to discover treasure by magic. This is inherently impossible. From the beginning itself, it is void. Subsequent impossibility means what? It is also called as supervening impossibility. Subsequent impossibility is also called as supervening impossibility. Supervening. It is also called as the doctrine of frustration. It is also called as doctrine of frustration. Subsequent impossibility, doctrine of frustration. So what do you mean by that? Doctrine of supervening impossibility. It means premature termination of a lawful contract. Premature means before maturity. Termination of a lawful contract. Something which is lawful, which is terminated before maturity. Premature termination of a lawful contract. Means what? Initially it is valid. Due to some reasons it becomes void. Initially it is valid. Due to some reasons it becomes void. Premature termination of a lawful contract. Due to certain intervening events or change of circumstances. Means what? You see. Guys. Initially, it is basically all the examples of void contract will come under subsequent impossibility. All the examples of void contract will come under subsequent impossibility. For example, death or personal incapacity. A contracts to act at a theater for 6 months for 5 lakh rupees paid in advance by B. On several occasions, A is too ill to act. The contract to act becomes what? Subsequently impossible. Initially it was valid, later it becomes void. Subsequently impossible. Destruction of the subject matter. Musical hall was agreed to be let out on certain dates, but before those dates the hall was destroyed by fire. Correct? Hall was destroyed by fire. Held the contract was what? Contract becomes void. Initially valid, later destruction of the subject matter. Held the contract was subsequently impossible. Subsequently void. Supervening impossibility. A and B contract to marry each other. Before the wedding only A goes mad. Oh! Contract becomes void. After the wedding A goes mad, valid. Correct? No. After the wedding A goes mad means it is valid. Valid ab initio. Okay. Fine. A in Bangalore contracts with B in Chennai to supply liquor. The government of Tamil Nadu declares trading in liquor as illegal. Obviously, contract becomes void. Supervening impossible.
Declaration of war. A in America contracts with B at Iraq to deliver a cargo by air. Destination Iraq. America declares war against Iraq. Contract becomes void on declaration of the war. Very, very simple. Initially valid, later void. These are all the examples of what doctrine of supervening impossibility. Now, tell me one thing. In Bangalore, believe it or not, there is a heli taxi service, helicopter taxi, from a place called Electronic City to Kempegowda International Airport, Bangalore Airport. I am not joking. There is a taxi service. This helicopter taxi will take 5000 rupees and 15 minute ride from Electronic City to airport. Let us say I have booked a ticket from Kempegowda International Airport to Chennai. Let's say ticket cost is just 2500 rupees. I have booked a ticket for 2500 rupees. Electronic City to Kempegowda International Airport is 5000 rupees. So basically 7500 I have paid. First of all, 5000 rupees to by helicopter and from there to Chennai. My objective is two objectives. One is I want to enjoy the aerial view. I want to enjoy the aerial view of Kempegowda International Air, I mean sorry, the entire Bangalore city. And also second important thing is what? One is I want to understand the aerial view. One is I want to enjoy the aerial view. Second important thing is what? I want to also definitely go to Chennai. Twofold objective. So I get on to the helicopter. I want to save time. Who will travel 3 hours, 4 hours to reach the airport? So I am going en route to the Kempegowda International Airport. I am enjoying the wonderful view of Bangalore city. 8 minutes, 9 minutes over, I get a message from my airline saying that your flight to Chennai has been cancelled. I am very sorry. Flight to Chennai cancelled. Very sorry. Guys, can I tell the pilot of the helicopter, sir, 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 stop there only, sir, enough. My house, I can see my house, stop there only, drop me down. Can you say yes or no? Obviously no. So guys, I cannot do that. Then can I say there is this, what do you say? I had taken some goods from somebody at 100 rupees forward contract. A supplier had told he'll supply goods to me at 100 rupees. Thinking that I had already sold it off, forward sale to a person for 120 rupees. As of today, I was making a profit of 20 rupees per kg, assume. Now what happened? This supplier was about to supply. He did not supply to me. Because of his breach, he committed a breach. Definitely I can sue him, that you leave. But I have already promised that I'll give it at 120. Now because of this stupid fellow, I need to take it from somebody else. And that fellow is charging me 120 rupees. Now my dear friends, I'm buying at 120, selling at 120, no profit, no loss. Can I come to this guy and cancel the contract saying that, sorry sir, this fellow did not supply? Definitely no. Definitely no. I cannot do that, guys. Partial impossibility is not supervening impossibility. Let's see some of the examples here. Partial impossibility. This is the example of my helicopter that I told you, but anyway, here A agreed to let out a boat to H. So one person A agreed to rent a boat to H to view the naval review of the king's coronation. Coronation is a ceremony where the king is appointed as a king or anointed as a king. I'm making him as a king, so it's a ceremony to celebrate that entire thing. So king's coronation ceremony is going on. So there is the entire navy which has stood around him and they are enjoying all those things. So I have let out a navy. The boat is there, the boat, I want to view this entire review. I want to, you know, go around the entire fleet also. Put one round around the fleet and enjoy the ceremony. So two objectives. One is what? To go around the entire fleet. Second one, to observe the ceremony. Two objectives. Unfortunately, the coronation got cancelled. But I was still in a position to go around this, but I did not go. Because of the king's illness, I did not go. The naval review was cancelled. But the fleet assembled and the boat could have been used to cruise around the fleet. Just like that, helicopter was going, other flight got cancelled. I cannot help it, guys. Contract can be discharged, cannot be discharged, cannot be discharged. Commercial impossibility, that's what? A stationer agreed to supply white paper at a single rate at a contracted price for 1 year. Later, due to an increase in the market price. Sir, market price increased, supplier did not give. I don't care. You should have considered all that and only then given me a quote. Due to a steep increase in market price, contractor stated that he would suffer very heavy loss by supplying at the contracted rates. So, stationer cannot claim that the contract can be discharged. I don't care. You should have thought about all this. You should have thought about all this before even coming to me. I can say that. Difficulty of performance. A agreed to supply coal within certain period. Due to government restriction on transport of coal, he failed to supply it in time. But coal was available in the open market from where A could have obtained it. Can you discharge the contract? No. A cannot be discharged. Why? I don't care if outside world they did not supply the goods. I have already taken the goods on board. I should supply to the other party. A promised to send certain goods from Bombay to Antwerp in September. In August, war broke out and shipping was not available. Held the increase of freight rates. Can excuse performance, cannot excuse performance, cannot excuse any performance as such. Nothing can be done. Default of a third party. A entered into a contract with B for supply of certain things manufactured by C. That's what I had ordered from C. Now C did not supply those goods anymore. What can I do? Can I go to him and say, sir, sorry sir, that person did not pay? No, A is not discharged and is liable to be for damages. And is definitely liable to be for damages. Then we have strike, lockout, etc. If there is a strike, lockout, civil disturbances, etc., I don't care. It will not disturb the, I don't care what happens about the strike, etc. It should not affect my contract in any way. If it affects my contract, then I can't help it. So in these cases, my dear friends, subsequent impossibility cannot be invoked in these cases. Subsequent impossibility cannot be invoked in these cases for sure. Because subsequent impossibility is only nothing but void contracts only, nothing else. Void contracts only, like death of the promisor, insolvency, merger of rights, all this we have already discussed. Initially valid, later void, like this, declaration of war, death or personal incapacity, all these things. That is called as impossibility of performance. So we have two things, subsequent impossibility and inherent impossibility. Inherent impossibility is void agreement, subsequent impossibility is void contract. Initially valid, later becomes void. So that is regarding impossibility of performance. So guys, as I told you, without fail, please follow me on unacademy.com/Punarvas Jayakumar. If you don't know what to do, go to any of my videos and check out the link here.
Punarvas Jai Kumar Sir's Unacademy profile. Once you click on that, it will take you here where you will see all my followers. You please follow me and you will see my special classes. Free classes. To enter the class, you just need to put the code PJ Sir Law. If you want a discount, you have to put the code PJ Sir Law. If you want this, you have to just put the code PJ Sir Law. Very, very, very simple, my dear friends. Extremely simple. And also, if you see here, any combo subscription or intermediate plus, and we have the iconic for CA Foundation and intermediate. All you need to do is just pick a plan. And once you say pick a plan, in this referral code, all you need to do is PJ Sir Law. And magic, you will get 10% off. So this is all you need to do, my dear friends. Very, very simple. Thank you so much for watching this video, my dear friends. Please, please, please subscribe to this channel. Hit the bell icon, because any important video released by me or any of the educators on this CA Foundation and Academy English channel, you will get a notification. Please like this video, share with among your friends, and also please leave your comments in the comment section. If you want to watch any special class of mine on the Unacademy platform, the code is PJ Sir Law. If you want to buy any product, the code is PJ Sir Law to get a 10% discount. Please download the Unacademy Learners app, and in the special class, you can also get all the notes as well. You can download. On that note, see you until next time, my dear friends. Love you all. Bye, my CA warriors. Cheers.